Hey there, welcome to another episode of Fly Fish Dan, and I'm Fly Fish Dan. If you like videos like this, give me a thumbs up. And if you're new to the channel, consider subscribing. You won't regret it. And consider leaving me a comment and tell me what you think of this video. All right, let's do this. Fish on. Wow, this is a nice fire. It's nothing better than a campfire. Yeah, so I discovered that I had a passion for saltwater tropical fishing way back when I was 25 years old. My dad bought me a trip to Christmas Island, just he and I and another group, to fish for bonefish. And, you know, he would tell me these stories about how these bonefish that were 12 or 13 inches in size could outfight a 20-pound salmon on a fly rod. I was just like, no way. And I was just enthralled with the idea of going to a tropical setting, this coral atoll that was literally in the middle of the Pacific Ocean, 140 miles off the equator. We flew into Hawaii, had a day there, and then flew due south, like 1,400 miles, and landed on this runway that was all these crab carcasses were all over the runway, because as the planes would come in once a week, they would run over all these crabs that would run across the runway. But just this very third world type of island nation, beautiful. I mean, the plane ride over, we flew over the island in the lagoon as we were coming in, and it was just gorgeous. I mean, it just, the anticipation was palpable. I mean, it was like, could not wait to get down there and cast the first cast. But there was a big check-in process and we had to go through customs and that type thing. But Christmas Island basically it's just a coral atoll. It's shaped kind of like those, if you ever done skeet shooting and those little manual things that throw the skeet? Well, it's shaped like that. And in that big mouth, there's a great big, about a 22 mile by 11 mile lagoon that's protected from the ocean. And there's a place called Nine Mile Flat. And it's called that because you can literally wade from ankle to waist deep water. It's like you're walking out in the middle of the ocean. I mean, you can walk for miles and miles, and there are these breaks in the coral, deep channels and slots that the bonefish will come out and feed on the flats and then go back down. So it's just this incredible fishery to where you're sight casting for, you know, whether it's a single bonefish or a whole entire school of bonefish. It's like nothing else that I've ever experienced. And so once we got all checked in and into our room, and of course a room, dear, they were like these grass huts, right, is what the accommodations were. There were some old military bases there on the island that they converted into these fishing lodges, and there was only a few. I think the most people that were ever on the island at any given time was there were under 30 anglers at any given time, so you rarely ran into anybody else fishing. So very remote fishery, but so cool. But we had an opportunity, so we just took a short truck ride to a flat that was near the lodge, and I hooked into my first bonefish, and it was just incredible. And it was only like this little 12-inch, 13-inch bonefish, but my dad was right. I mean, it fought harder than any steelhead that I've landed on a fly rod. It was incredible. I couldn't believe what I reeled it in. It's just this little teeny bonefish. I thought, what is it going to be like when I hook into one that's, you know, 16, 17, or close to 20 inches? It just is crazy. And I hooked into several that were that big, several that were pushing the 20-inch mark, probably 3 to 4 pounds. I mean, the only way that I can describe it is if you see a guy screaming by in a jet ski, and you make the cast, and you accidentally hook the back of the jet ski, and that thing just takes off. I have not had a fish pull more line out faster than a bonefish. I mean, it's nuts. I mean, that's what it's like. It's absolutely incredible. And from the scenery to the fishing, to the flats, to the people, I mean, it really was an incredible experience. I mean, something I'll never forget. And so that trip there, you know, you're there for about, you have about 7 days, 7 full days of fishing. You have to be gone 10 days to be able to make the entire trip because of the, you know, over 2 days it gets you to get there and a full 24 hours to get back. So it's a tough trip on you physically, but man, you know, Do you ever have a passion for fishing tropical and you want to catch a bonefish? Christmas Island, Kiribati, that's where you need to go. So the next trip, I took my godson. So I taught my godson, Ren, how to fish or how to fly fish. And, you know, told him these stories and he was like, God, when are we going to go? So, gosh, it was probably 20 years later, probably 12 or 13 years later, I went to Christmas Island again. And Ren had the opportunity to experience what I experienced at Christmas Island. And he was also, he was hooked. I mean, he now arguably is a better bone fisherman than I, because he was so, he had so much passion for it. He actually moved to Hawaii for a couple of years to fish bonefish and invited me on a few fishing excursions over to Hawaii and showed me all of his secret spots. And we caught some big bonefish. But Christmas Island, it's on that trip with Ren. Oh my God, I caught a giant trevally that was pushing 100 pounds. So the guides would kind of estimate based off of the girth and the size of how much this thing weighed, but it was nearly 100 pounds. And I caught this thing on a fly rod. It was like nothing else. Bonefish are like casting at a jet ski. Well, catching a giant trevally is like hooking onto a freight train that's speeding down the tracks at about 60 miles an hour, and there is just no stopping them.